chat, analytics, and making money with live streams. There are lots of things to think about while you're live streaming, so here are a few key tips, as well as some suggestions for what to do after you finish. Managing your chat can be a big task, so one way to get help is by assigning moderators. Once assigned, moderators can interact with the audience and manage the chat to keep the conversation going the way you want it. That way, you can focus on being on camera. If you want to make sure the conversation stays positive and in tune with your brand, you can make sure certain words don't show up in your chat stream by adding them to the blocked words list, located under Community Settings. If your moderators are overwhelmed or you don't have someone to help, slow mode can also make chat management easier. It slows the time between comments, limiting the frequency if you plan to be both on camera and monitoring chat. Now that you've got chat down, let's talk about analytics. Real-time analytics gives you valuable feedback on your stream, like the number of viewers, likes, and chat messages, or even if the stream is working at all. The level of reporting will differ slightly for each type of stream you choose, with events being the most in-depth. These stats will then roll over into YouTube analytics within 24 to 72 hours, depending on the stream type. After your live stream is over, you can use YouTube analytics to see how it went. To find out when the most people were watching, check the timing of peak concurrence. For example, you can use that data to figure out when viewers left the stream, which can give you an idea of what segments might not have worked so well. You can also use other metrics to gauge the stream's impact. Did you gain subscribers? How long did people watch for? Did people like the questions you asked? Did your stream attract the type of viewers you wanted? What were the traffic sources? You can use this information to plan out your next stream and make any necessary adjustments. Once you've hit a groove with your streaming schedule and programming, it's time to think about making money with your live stream. If you want to make money from streaming, start by making sure your channel has monetization enabled. Ads can serve on your streams once your stream is over, like you can on regular videos. You can use real-time analytics to track how the audience responds and adjust your monetization strategy accordingly. Since your stream will be uploaded to your library when it's done, you can enable monetization on that video as well. But you can also make money from your live stream without ads as well. Let's talk Super Chat. Super Chat lets viewers buy a brightly colored message that stays pinned for a set period of time. If you have Super Chat enabled, viewers can click the dollar sign, pay some money, and have their chat message stand out. So how do you get more Super Chats? The most important thing is rewarding the people who give them to you. You can get excited when you get one, or give the superfan a shout out, or even tell your viewers to hashtag the superfan's name in the comments. Some creators give preference to Super Chat questions when they're doing Q&A streams. If you have too many Super Chats to call them out individually, consider taking a moment to thank all your superfans at once. Got all that? Thanks for watching! What kind of prompts do you use to get your fans to engage with your live stream? Let us know in the comments, and don't forget to subscribe!